I greeted their Steve Jobs Theater with a monologue from the late Steve Jobs himself. It was truly touching. But Apple's keynote just wrapped up, and there's a lot to go through, so this video is going to be a quick rundown of what got announced, and I'll do individual videos on each product later this week. We've got the iPhone 10, which is spelled with a Roman numeral X. We've got the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 8 Plus, the Apple Watch Series 3, the Apple TV 4K, and we even got a sneak peek at the AirPower. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and you can watch some of my other videos here after you're done watching this video. Now let's get into this. First, let's go over the most important announcement, and that's the iPhone 10. You've probably seen this phone by now, but here are the most important details. The iPhone 10 is going to come in only two colorways, space gray and silver. It's going to come in two storage capacities, 64 gigs and 256 gigs. The 64 gig model is going to retail for $999, and the 256 gig model is going to retail for $1,149, something Tim Cook did not mention on stage. Pre-orders start on October 27th, and they will start shipping out on November 3rd. But what do you get on a $1,000 phone from Apple? You get an iPhone with almost no bezels, new Face ID, which admittedly does use a whole lot of sensors and processing power to work properly and keep your data safe, presumably, slightly better cameras on both the front and back, and a battery life that's 2 hours longer than the iPhone 7. The iPhone 10 also has a 5.8-inch Super Retina display, which is supposed to look better than the Retina HD display on the new iPhone 8, a stainless steel body with curved glass panels on both the front and back, and overall just faster internals for faster performance than the iPhone 8. And speaking of the iPhone 8, Apple has announced the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 8 Plus. The iPhone 8 will come in three colorways, silver, space gray, and a different shade of gold, and they will also come in 64 or 256 gig capacities. The 64 gig iPhone 8 will retail for $699, and the 256 model will retail for $849. The 64GB iPhone 8 Plus will retail for $799, and the 256GB model will retail for $949. Pre-orders on the iPhone 8 models start much sooner than the iPhone 10 on September 15th, or this Friday, and they will start shipping on September 22nd. The iPhone 8 shares the same design as the iPhone 6 and the iPhone 7. It has the same bezels and home bind on the front, except the iPhone 8 now has glass panels on both the front and back, just like the iPhone 10. The glass panel back on both iPhones means they will have wireless charging, and they're using the Qi standard, which is a good move. Upgrades to the iPhone 8 are pretty standard. Better screen, better cameras for picture, and 25% faster than the previous model. So for your average consumer, what's the main difference between the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 10? Basically, the iPhone 10 has that brand new bezel-less design. Better cameras, faster processing power, no home button, and Face ID. The iPhone 10 also has a slightly larger screen coming in at 5.8 inches, while the iPhone 8 Plus has a screen that's coming in at 5.5 inches and a body with a larger footprint. But Apple isn't being direct about battery life on the iPhone 10. So real-world battery life on the iPhone 10 might not be as good as the iPhone 8. But that's just me speculating, so don't kill me down in the comments down below. But both of these phones are water and dust resistant, and they both have wireless charging. And they're both using the Qi standard, which means they will work with the same wireless charging pads like most other Android devices. And Apple even gave us a sneak peek at their own wireless charging pad, which can charge multiple Apple devices at the same time. They call it the AirPower. There was no mention of release date, but it can charge your iPhone, Apple Watch, and AirPods at the same time. And speaking of the AirPods, Apple will be releasing an updated AirPod with a charging case that has wireless charging capabilities. But there was no mention of release date for that either, but it's just a minor update for the AirPods anyway. The second biggest announcement at Apple's event today was the Apple Watch Series 3. It has the same body as the Apple Watch Series 2, and there are whole new wristbands to choose from. Basically, there's an Apple Watch to suit everyone's style, but there is now a cellular and non-cellular model. The easiest way to spot an Apple Watch Series 3 with cellular capabilities is that it has a red digital crown. The cellular Apple Watch Series 3 will allow you to take calls straight from your wrist even if you leave your iPhone at home, and you'll be able to stream your own music. Starting with the non-cellular model, the Apple Watch Series 3 starts off at $329 with the 38mm aluminum case and the sport band. And the 42mm aluminum case starts at $359. The Apple Watch Series 3 with cellular capabilities with the 38mm aluminum aluminum case and a sport band starts at $399. And the 42mm case starts at $449. Obviously, with more premium case materials and bands, the price of the Apple Watch Series 3 will go up. And there are also going to be Apple Watch Series 3 Nike Plus editions with new and exclusive wristbands. Pre-orders for the Apple Watch Series 3 start on September 15th, and they will start shipping out on September 22nd. And I just wanted to point out, the Apple Watch Series 1 is still on sale, starting at $249, but it looks like the Apple Watch Series 2 is now going to be retired. That's a low blow, because the Apple Watch Series 1 isn't waterproof. And finally, there's the Apple TV 4K, which is an updated Apple TV that can stream in 4K, as the name implies. But it also has high dynamic range, aka HDR, which means better color and picture quality. It's also using the A10X Fusion chip, which is the same found in the iPad Pro. It delivers 2x CPU and 4x better graphic performance than the past Apple TV, and if you bought a movie from iTunes in HD, it will automatically be upgraded to 4K. Obviously, in order to enjoy the new Apple TV 4K to its fullest, you need to also have a 4K TV. The Apple TV 4K will come in two storage options, 32 and 64 gigs, and will retail for $179 and $199 respectively. And just like the Apple Watch and the iPhone 8, pre-orders start on September 15th, and they are going to be shipping out on September 22nd. But who are we kidding? The Apple TV 4K isn't going to sell out. And that's a quick rundown of Apple's keynote today. The iPhone 10 will be shipping out in November, while everything else like the iPhone 8, iPhone 8 Plus, Apple Watch Series 3, and the Apple TV 4K will be shipping out this September 22nd. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on the videos going into these new Apple products. I'll see you guys next time.
Hey, if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. It helps out more than you realize. For more product reviews and deal alerts, check out gymcaddy.net.